this is something has been carved to be used as a burial tool. It is really depicting or representing what the Nabat believe in, which is the death and life after death. They believe the second life. They believe that they, when they die, their souls will go up to higher heaven. When they come back to life, and they will continue living within the same place. They also found burial structures where they buried the people and the buildings. If they come back to life again, they will be alive and already living in the cave that they gave time to the carver. At that time, it was flourishing. This is something like a real estate nowadays. Look at the building. It is two levels. The first level, there's a middle big room, benches has been carved from inside, another two rooms to the outside. And this is considered a big house compared to what existed at that time. And then they took the dead bodies and they put them for their last rest in the higher level. Hallway, the corridor that was winding in between the mountains that we have to go through to make it eventually in the city center. On the sandstone rocks, then the water over so many years flushed it the way that we are seeing it like that. For the newly established kingdom at that time, they looked around and they chose this particular place for its fortification, my friend, to defend the city. Now, the Nabatean officials, they were businessmen. They traveled along the 14th caravanserai. The Nabatean main god name was Du al-Shara, and Du al-Shara most of the time appeared with another two female trinity gods, Al-Lat and Al-Uzza, also believed in by ancient Arabs existed in the Arabian Peninsula and around here. In between the mountains that would allow the flash floods in the sea again, the Nabatean built dams. This one is restoration by the government. This one is the original dam base. They made here a hole and they broke that with a rock. So whenever there's also enough amount of water, they would loosen that and they would get all the water and take it where they are gathering. To Petra must go through this sea. This is the only entrance of Petra. And look how easy to defend, really. It takes just a few soldiers in both sides, dumping big rocks, oil. The Mediterranean Sea was named the Roman Sea because the Romans controlled all the cities or the countries that were or are surrounding the Mediterranean.
Wait, look up. I want to go.
In the desert. Here in the east, we call it the desert, the ship of the desert. It is an animal that can last for up to 2 weeks without any food.
Yeah.
It's more surplus space. This is where the name of the treasury came from, that belief that those people had in their mind early 19th century, before really creating Transjordan. Bedouin around here thought, believed that all the treasures has been hidden in that big urn. So they were standing right here with their gun machine, shooting at it, thinking it's going to break off and the gold would spill out.
Inside the house that they carved for themselves for the second life. This is exactly the idea of the caves. The Nabataeans did not live in those caves.
The reason for that is that it is a place that was lived for almost 1,000 years. Rain, wind, bringing a dust, a ruffle.
It takes you to a higher back mountain where they had the official sacrifice place on top of that mountain where the Nabataeans took their animals and they did the sacrifices.
The town is divided into two sections really. The holy site, the sacred site where they had all the caves, and the rest of town just comes down from the theater. Yeah.
Maybe half of them can now.
Yeah, man. All right. Nice picture. You know what? One more.
The palace, there to that, the first one to that side, that direction. We see the palace, that is a three stories cave. The first and second levels are perfectly there. You see all the carved pillars. The third one, half of it has been carved, the other half they built that using bricks.
But that is the fourth, my friend, was it the only thing of Petra. There were a series of things. And so this part of the mountain has been dedicated, designated for the rest of the kings. Each one had his own cave to be buried. What happened is that there is a mixed architecture between ancient Nabatean and Roman architecture. This came after Christianity prevailed, my friends. So the people of Petra, after everyone believed in Christianity, after became in need for a church. So they looked around for a good place to use it as a church. And so they looked around, they went to that cave. Forget about this steps and arches. We want to go just to the cave. When they went into the cave, they found that this is one of the biggest caves in Petra. Or the restaurant from this point is going to take between an hour and 15 minutes. Depends on the taste that you guys are with. But stop. To be honest with you, I want to show you the rest of the city from a distance. We will come to the market of ancient Petra, the city center of ancient Petra. You guys seeing those standing columns? This is a part of what is known as the colonnaded road. Public buildings also took a place along the side of this road. That is the Petra downtown, Petra city center. My friends, if you ask me about the Nabatean themselves, I mean their houses built using those bricks facing down the area of, or spread around those two hills surrounding the area of downtown. The two earthquakes that we talked about, that's what made the Nabatean houses look like. They are completely demolished. If you focus little, you can still see some bricks built on top of each other.
Grida forte!